Thank you. Good morning. And following the motto of this conference, I would like to present how we have built a bridge between two projects. On one shore of the river Dolia, the documentation management system of the Inrap, and on the other shore, Ariadne, an European project ended in January 2017, and where Inrap has been a partner. Before to start, I would like to thank all the colleagues involved in this project, and in particular, Emmanuel Brias, co-author of this contribution. Some context information. So the French National Institute for Preventive Archaeological Research, INRAP, was created in 2002 in application of the National Law on Preventive Archaeology, according to the Valletta Convention. The institute ensures the detention and the study of archaeological remains concerned by construction projects in France and its overseas territory. It exploits and diffuses the results of its research to the scientific community and participates in teaching, cultural diffusion, and public outreach. The RAP has today 2,000 collaborators and researchers in 40 research centers. It manages more than 200 archaeological excavations and approximately 2,000 diagnostic operations by trial trenches per year. And for each operation, the Institute produces an archaeological report. It means a huge amount of documentation. So, as I just said, the operations produced a considerable mass of documents, particularly since the development of digital technologies. It's a heterogeneous mass of documents, different by the degree of elaboration of the message carried, expression vector, support of the technique implemented. And quite naturally, the operation report imposed itself as a point of entry, as an administrative document. Its content is set by law since 2004. It's a decree of 27 September 2004. As activity report, which contains a series of seven regulatory inventories listing the stratigraphic units, the archaeological structures, furniture uncovered, the samples taken, the graphic, photographic, written, paper or digital document produced. As a scientific document, so proposing a first interpretation as close as possible to the sources of the site unearthed, and as a patrimonial document, because it preserves the memory of the operation. In 2006, the Institute decided to collect, classify, inventory the old documentation, the old documentary collections. In addition to the books and the periodicals purchased, the main purpose is to take available the results of the archaeological operations carried out by the Institute. The aim was to set up a unique tool allowing at least the reporting, referencing, and location of the documents kept by the institution. Several arguments prevailed in the choice of the IT solution. The catalog had to be able to be fed and consulted simultaneously on different sites. A client-server solution was so essential. The selected software would allow access to the electronic version of the document from the catalog record. And the chosen solution should guarantee the interoperability of the data, in particular with the other documentary catalogs relating to archaeology. So we choose a proprietary integrated library system named Flora, respecting the international UNIMARC standard and making full text consultation possible. The UNIMARC format is a variant of the machine-readable catalog format, the MARC format for the exchange of computerized bibliographic data from library catalogs. To unify the descriptions and facilitate the linking of the documents, it was decided to describe their content using a controlled and structured vocabulary. Each document in the catalogue is described using the Pactols, the place, subject, chronologies, and people's microthesaurus of the Pactols thesaurus of the CNRS network Frantiq. This thesaurus, specialized in archaeology from prehistory to the industrial era, is multilingual, polyhierarchical, evolutionary, but above all, standardized. It meets the standards for semantic interoperability, and in particular the ISO 25964, and above all the SCOS recommendation, the System Knowledge Organization Standard. The use of thesaurus controlled vocabulary and structured by semantic and hierarchical relationships to describe the context of the documents allows a unification to the descriptions and facilitates their connection. Indeed, the principle of a thesaurus is to avoid semantic ambiguities. It's used to describe the reports of archaeological operations conducted throughout the national territory, allows to connect discoveries made in different archaeological contexts. Through the alignment with other vocabularies, the data of the Inrap could be put into perspective with those of the other institutions, in particular in a new European framework like the platform Ariadne. Nowadays, the reasoned management of the operational reports has offered a framework that makes it possible to consider the availability of all the documentation produced by excavations. The export of that of data in Ariadne and in the Frantiq catalogue has proved the interoperability of Dolia's data. And so, Ariadne. Ariadne is an EU-funded project aimed at integrating existing archaeological data infrastructures across Europe, so researchers can use the various distributed data sets and new technologies to explore new research methodologies. Ariadne was managed by a partnership joining the excellence of European archaeology and technology and opened to the collaboration of researchers, professionals, and institutions from anywhere in Europe and abroad. So some figures about the Ariadne community, but I skip because of time. The aim of the Ariadne infrastructure is, above all, the data sharing, mobilizing, integrating, and making accessible the data. That means interoperability. So each partner brought their own data without changing the original format. The choice has been to do a mapping between each dataset and a catalog data model, the ACDM, Ariadne Catalog Data Model. In our case study, the French one, we did the mapping between the UNIMARC fields and the of Dolia and the ACDM. This is an example. On the left side, the field name, in the center, the UNIMARC code. On the right side, the related field in the ACDM, inherited from other standards, as the Dublin Core or the digital catalog terms. The choice done in the Ariadne project has been to investigate the data by using three principal questions in archaeology. What, where, when? To answer the first question, what, at the Inrap we did an alignment between our thesaurus, the Pactols, and the thesaurus chosen in the Ariadne project, the AAT of the Paul Getty Museum. The results were quite good, and as you can see in the table, on almost 2,000 concepts, the 71% exact alignment and almost the 21% broader concept. The work has been done by using a simple spreadsheet, as you can see in the image, linked in a source term in French and a target term in English. These works allowed us to link the whole subjects with the data of other countries with a really useful multi-language approach. Here you can see the extended results linked not only by the single to the single term, but to the occurrences in our database. The second question has been where. To answer to this question, we did a more complicated work because in our system and in UNIMARC, in Dolia, The spatial information was implemented in a textual way as an address, as addresses. So we had to translate these addresses in couples of coordinates by using some API online, as those published online by the French National Institute of Geography. In this case, the results has been less accurate than for the subjects, of course. As you can see in the table, only 13% correspond to an exact point. The biggest part correspond to a centroid placed in the middle of a municipality. Furthermore, we should consider some trouble due to a wrong filling of the Dolia form. As presented in this case, for example, a wrong postal code avoids an accurate geocoding. So, anyway, if we consider the results at a different scale, it's the first time that the whole archaeological operation of the Inrap, almost 30,000, can be displayed on a map. By using a leaflet, a web mapping library, we produced some heat map and a cluster map. Last question. One. In this case, the alignment has been between the terms used in Dolia, inherited from the Pactols thesaurus, and the online gazetteer Periodo. We mapped 124 chronological concepts covering the whole France extensions, and we attribute a time span, a large time span for cover the whole nation, for each period. In the Ariadne portal, it's so possible to search records by using the timeline graph that represents the occurrences in a graphical way. And for us, for example, we can compare two different regions of France, looking at a glance, the difference between them. At the end, the result is the publication of the old Dolia database in the Ariadne portal, which has been developed by the technical partners of Ariadne, as the Italian CNR, the German DAI, and the Swedish SND. As you can see, all the data published are already ready to be linked open data. Of course, each record is linked to the original source with an URI that allows to go directly to the Dolia web page. In conclusion, Dolia was originally designed as a traditional library catalog, allowing the references and location of the institute's document library. Very quickly, the growing number of digital documents and the advent of the web of data have necessitated the development of a digital library. Dolia, in a context of putting Inrap data into perspective with the archaeological data of other institutions, appears as a source of metadata to describe the general scientific framework of the operation. With the export of Dolia's data in Ariadne, we switch from a database focused on a paper to a database focused on archaeological finds, or rather, from a tool for documentary research to a tool for information retrieval. Our perspective and our hope, of course, is to bring together all the projects developed at the Inrap as presented by our colleagues during this conference, for example, Christophe Tufferi, about the experimentation of the CDOCCRM on data on Inrap's databases to achieve the interoperability between different databases, or Anne Moreau on the experimentation about spatial data and the construction of a web mapping and spatial data infrastructure. Thanks to all those projects and to the experience gained during the Ariadne project, we are now ready to make some step forward towards a unified system that should be able to manage the all data produced during the archaeological operations. The result should be an archaeological information system, an AIS, open and shared online, that would allow to a various audience the access to the all data. We personally think that is the only way to build a bridge towards the future and to manage and preserve the archaeological data of our institution. So, thank you for your attention.